Good morning, children. Welcome to today's program. My name is Echika from Elijah. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. We glorify your holy name. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your abundant blessings. We thank you, Lord Jesus, over our family. We thank you, Lord Jesus, over our household. We thank you, Lord Jesus, over our going out and our coming in. Lord Jesus, we magnify your holy name. We give you praise. We give you honor. Thank you, Father God. Thank you for today's word, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord, because we won't be the only viewer of the world, but the doers of your word. Lord, we magnify your holy name. We give you praise. We give you honor. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. And amen. So, children, let's get our writing materials ready for today's work. Remain blessed.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. In the beginning, God made everything. God simply spoke and the world came to be. He sent a flood and made everything new. He parted the sea and let his people walk through. He helped a boy bring a giant right down. Joshua marched the walls bound to the ground. These acts of power are worthy of praise. But if you want to question my God and his ways,
I'll look you in the eye and say,
my God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do.
Sinners, he still gave us worth. God sent his son to live here on the earth. He healed the sick, he made blind men see. He let the lame walk and he set the world free.
He died on a cross and he rose from the grave. He conquered sin, he is mighty to save. He went to heaven and he's coming back. God's word is true, but if it's attack, I'll look you in the eye and say, my God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do.
God the Spirit, God the Father, God the Son.
One plus one plus one equals one.
Hello, this month we'll be talking about responsibility. Today we'll be talking about being responsible for our choices. What we become depends on what we think about all the time. We are responsible for what? For our choices. For what we choose to do, say, and think. For example, at school, if someone is saying bad words to you, it's your responsibility to choose the way you react. Remember, the Bible says, don't repay evil for evil. Lastly, the way your life, what happens in your life, you are responsible for it. Thank you.
I am a child of God. I delight in God's word. I think on his word both day and night. I am like a tree planted by the rivers of water. I bring forth my fruit in its season. My leaves do not wither, and whatever I do prospers. God is the strength of my life. I can do anything with Jesus in me. I am taught of the Lord, and his peace belongs to me. I am the light of the world. I will let my light shine all the time, so everyone can see Jesus in me. I flourish like a palm tree, and I grow like a cedar in Lebanon. I am planted in the house of the Lord, and I flourish in the courts of my God. I grow in grace and God's favor. I always bear fruit in all areas of my life. I am full of spiritual vitality. I am rich in love. I will always respect and obey my father and mother, so my life will be long and good. Thank you, Father, that your angels watch over me. I have the assurance that you will never leave me alone or give up on me. I excel in everything I do. This year, it is my year of more in Jesus' name. I am a flourishing child. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Children, it's another time to hear God's word. I'm sure we've been enjoying service from the beginning. Now we're going to share God's word. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for another opportunity to hear your word. We depend on you, Holy Spirit, to speak to us. And Lord, you will help us that we'll not just be hearers of this word, but that we'll be doers of it, and your name will be glorified. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Yes, it's time to hear God's word. Let's get our Bibles. I have mine. Do you have yours? Get your Bibles, your biros, your pencil, your notebooks, and let us start. Wow. Today is going to be another interesting time. And so I want you to follow me. And I'll be talking about something interesting, something I know that you've experienced before, something that has happened to you before and you're wondering why, how. It's called emotions. What did I say? Emotions. And we were talking about managing your emotions, how to manage your emotions. You see, emotions are our feelings, is how we express our feelings. And we express our feelings based on so many things. I'm sure you've heard of this word before, six senses. Yes, our emotions, you know, are based on how we feel, and our feelings are influenced by what we see, what we hear, what we smell, what we taste, what we do, and at times the things that are done to us. Those are the things that influences our emotions a lot of times. You know, there's so many emotions that we express as children and as adults. And today I'll be talking about a few things and how to manage them. Do you know any emotion that you can think of the way you are right now? Let me hear them. Fantastic. Wow. Good children. Yes, there's so many. When you're happy, yippee, it's an emotion. When you're sad, when you're angry, when you're afraid, when you're embarrassed, when you're in pain, they're all different types of emotions. And you see, God actually put these emotions in us. Remember, we've talked about the spirit, the soul, and the body that makes who you are. You are a spirit, you have a soul, and you live in a body. And you see, these emotions are as a result of our soul. And we express them in different ways. It is our soul that is coming into play in our feelings. And so, we can be in control of our emotions if we want to. Yes, you can actually be in control. Tell yourself, I'm the master of my emotions. You know, let me give you an example. If someone hits you right now, you can choose to be angry that your friend hit you. But you can choose to say that, I don't like how you hit me, but I forgive you. You have chosen to walk in love. But if you decide to hit the person back, it's an emotion and you have expressed it. But you are in charge. You can be in control of your emotions. So what am I talking about today? I'm talking about how to manage those emotions that come as a result of what somebody has done to you, what somebody has said to you, because somebody tells you that you are not fine and you can decide to start crying, expressing an emotion. But if you tell the person, I'm fearfully made, I'm beautifully made, you have expressed another emotion. So that takes us to our memory verse for today. Let's open our Bibles to 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. You know, God actually gave us these emotions. And you see, emotions are neither good nor bad, but it's the way you choose to express it. If you decide that you are happy for somebody that is doing, that something good has happened to, you have expressed your emotions in a good way. But if you are happy that somebody fell down, you have expressed your emotions in a bad way. Happiness is a good emotion, but you have expressed it in a bad way. So emotions in itself are neither good nor bad. But what, how you express it is what determines whether it is good or bad. Let us open our Bibles to 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. And it says, "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind." God did not give us a spirit of fear. You know, we can feel fear. Fear can come because of what we have seen. Something terrified you. But it doesn't mean that you have that spirit. So you will tell yourself, when you feel fear, you will tell yourself, "This is not of God. God did not give me the spirit of fear." And so you will express boldness. You will express power because you are able to manage your emotions. So tell yourself, "I'm the master of myself. I'm the master of my emotions." So God has not given us a spirit of fear. And that's our memory verse. Make sure you write it down. You're going to learn that and, you know, ponder on it. Think about it. Meditate on it. That God has not given you the spirit of fear. So like I was saying about emotions, it depends on how you express it. I know there's a particular one that is really common amongst us. Not only as adults, but as children. And that is anger. Have you been angry about anything before? When you're angry, "My mommy beats me. My mommy did not give me what I want. My daddy did not. My sibling did not." And you're angry. Let me read a scripture to you. It's in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26. Are you there? I'll wait for you a bit. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26. It says, "Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your wrath." Verse 27 says, "Nor give place to the devil." He says you can be angry, but do not sin. Because there's a tendency that when you're angry, "You will not be my friend again. I don't love you. I don't like you. I don't want to be your friend. Don't sit beside me. I will not give you something." Because you're angry. The Bible says that when you're angry, when you're expressing that emotion, it said, "Do not sin. And do not let the sun go down on your wrath." That means don't go to bed saying that, "My daddy did not give me this thing," and then you now go to bed and you're angry. The Bible says you should not. It says, "And do not give place to the devil." So who will give the place to the devil? You. So who will decide not to give place to the devil? It is you. So you are the master. You are the one that will manage your emotions. So we need, as children of God, we need to manage our emotions. Basically, that's what I'm talking about today. Managing our emotions. And you know, there's some things we can do to help ourselves to manage our emotions. Some of those things are, we need to study God's word. You see, I've read it in the Bible that it says, "Be angry, but do not sin." But if you don't study God's word, if you don't read God's word, you won't see that it is there. So you need to read God's word. Tell yourself, "I'll read God's word and I'll manage my emotions." Another thing that you can do is you have to depend on the Holy Spirit. How many of you have the Holy Spirit in you? I do. So if you have the Holy Spirit in you, you need to manage your emotions, depending on the Holy Spirit to help you to manage your emotions. So I'll tell you three steps, practical steps to manage your emotions. The first thing is, when anything happens, you stop. The second thing is, you think. And the third thing is, you act. So when anything happens to you, stop. Take a break. Don't react immediately. Then the next thing, think. What will Jesus do? Have you heard that before? WWJD. What will Jesus do? Will Jesus fight? Will Jesus beat? Will Jesus do this? What will Jesus do? Then the third thing is, you now act. Act out what you think Jesus will do. So have you learned something today? I hope you have. What I've learned is that our emotions are given to us by God. Our emotions can be managed because we are the master of our emotions. Emotions are neither good nor bad, but what I do with it is what determines. And when anything happens to me, before I react, I will stop, I will think, and then I will act. And what I will do is, what will Jesus do? WWJD. I hope you have learned something today. God bless you. Father, we thank you for your word today. Thank you for teaching us. Oh God, help us to be able to put this to practice. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. children. It's time to give our offerings. I hope you came to church with your offerings. All right, so let the basket go around and we give our offering. And let's listen to the following announcement. Have you done your Bible Man challenge? If you haven't, make sure you do it this week and you submit it. It's another time to study God's word. And we're talking about our Bible heroes. Who is your Bible hero? Make sure you do it this week. Praise the Lord. Now it's time to share our grace. Let us go ahead. I am an overcomer. I will keep God's word in my heart to observe and to practice in faith, in love, and in joy. I will live sensitive to the Spirit, thereby making my way prosperous this week and enjoy success as God's light to the glory of my Father. Amen. Have a beautiful week. Bye.